The nucleic acids are our final type of biological molecule. Nucleic acids are very special. They're specialized to be able to store information and also to encode proteins. So they store information and they allow that information to be used inside of cells. Nucleic acids are polymers. They are polymers that are built from nucleotides. So we're going to be talking about what is a nucleotide. Let's just start with the basics. A nucleotide consists of three things. It always has a sugar molecule. It also always has a phosphate group. And finally, it always has what's called a nitrogen base. So let's take a look at some pictures. By the way, nucleic acids include DNA, which I'm sure you've heard of, and they also include RNA, which you may or may not have heard of. We'll be talking about what this is shortly. We'll really be talking about it in a later section, but we'll introduce it here today. Okay, so these nucleotides, let's take a look at some pictures. We're going to compare a DNA nucleotide with an RNA nucleotide. Let's start on the left with DNA. So a DNA nucleotide, again, it has a sugar in blue. This is the sugar right here. This sugar is named deoxyribose. We've got a phosphate group highlighted over here in yellow. This phosphate group is always connected to the sugar. And then finally, we have a nitrogen base. This is a molecule that has nitrogens in it. You can see some nitrogens there in the ring structure. And this base, this particular one that's being shown right here, is called a thymine. We abbreviate that with a T. In the case of DNA, there are four bases that are possible at this location. It'll either be a T, an A, a G, or a C. And we'll come back to that in more detail later on. So that's a DNA nucleotide. How is an RNA nucleotide any different? Let me put it down here. If you glance at the structure, it looks very similar. We've got a phosphate group, just like we did in DNA. We've got a nitrogen base, just like we did in DNA. And we've got a sugar, just like we did in DNA. So what's the big difference? Well, the primary difference is in the sugar structure. Okay? In the case of RNA, right here, we've got an OH group. In the case of DNA, right here, we have just an H group. That's why this is called deoxyribose. Okay, this was ribose. The sugar here is called ribose. If we take that oxygen away, now we're left with deoxyribose. It has had an oxygen removed. So that's really it. That's the key difference. It's a very tiny, subtle difference. RNA versus DNA. In terms of the nitrogen base, RNA has a special base, and that base is called uracil. It's represented with a U, capital U. Okay, so RNA has uracil instead of thymine, but otherwise the bases are the same. A, G, and C, those show up in both DNA and RNA. Nucleotides can be connected together to form a polymer, and they are attached by means of a dehydration reaction, just like we've seen before. So here's a schematic of a polymer of nucleotides that have been linked together. So here's one nucleotide in the box right here. Here's the next nucleotide right there with an A. Here's the next nucleotide with a C. Okay, so we've got a whole chain of nucleotides connected together. And we already noted that in the case of DNA, there are four possible nucleotides. Four possible nitrogen bases. Each of these bases, it turns out, likes to pair with a neighbor. And we've got some base pairing rules. We're going to introduce these now. We'll see them again later on in the course when we talk about DNA in more detail. But A, it turns out, always likes to pair with T. And conversely, T always likes to pair with A. G always likes to pair with C. And C always likes to pair with G. So those are the base pairing rules. Again, we'll see these again later on in the course. So if we take this into consideration, the fact that things like to pair up, here we go. DNA tends to be double-stranded. It tends to form what's called a double strand or a double helix. And that's just due to the base pairing that's taking place, right? So here's one strand of DNA. And here is another strand of DNA. They kind of tend to wind around each other and form this double helix.